Hey everyone, Dr. Jeff Peng here. Platelet-rich plasma injections are an exciting new treatment option in the world of orthopedics and sports medicine. It's being used to treat all sorts of injuries and painful conditions, but because it is still relatively new, a lot of people have questions about them. So in this video, I want to answer all the most common questions that I get about PRP. Let's dive right in. Now, if this is the first time you are watching one of my videos, my goal is to help each and every one of you live an active and healthy lifestyle. So if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing to my channel. So the first question that I get is, what is PRP? PRP stands for platelet-rich plasma, and PRP injections fall under this big umbrella category of treatment called orthobiologics or regenerative medicine. And in this category of treatment, we're actually using your own body's capacity to help control pain, to help control inflammation, and then using it to treat a painful condition. And so what are platelets? Platelets are these tiny cells that naturally circulate in your body. They are incredibly important in trying to promote recovery. So they're really important in tissue proliferation, tissue healing, controlling pain, and controlling inflammation. PRP also contains an incredible amount of growth factors. All these growth factors are naturally circulating around in your body. And so we're taking all of your platelets and your growth factors out and using them to treat a painful problem. So what is the PRP injection process? Step one is we get your platelets. So what we do is we actually draw your blood. We use a very tiny needle and we draw your blood into a very special tube. We then put this tube into a centrifuge, and when it spins down, your blood separates out into layers. We take the layer that has all of your platelets and your growth factors in it, and then under ultrasound guidance, we inject it back into an area that's been irritated. Start to finish, the whole process takes about 30 to 40 minutes. The entire process is relatively painless, and in most situations, you're able to drive home right afterwards. What do we use PRP to treat in orthopedics? Well, there is a rapidly growing body of evidence supporting the use of PRP in treating many conditions involving the joints, tendons, muscles, ligaments, and bones. Out of all of these indications, by far the best studied indication and by far the best use of PRP seems to be used in the treatment of osteoarthritis, and especially osteoarthritis of the knee. Now, hip osteoarthritis has also been shown to be really beneficial. Elbow tendinopathies such as tennis elbow and golfer's elbow are also extensively studied, where PRP injections are by far better than other types of injections that we have been using. Very well-studied indications also include plantar fasciitis and gluteal tendinopathies. Gluteal tendinopathies involve pain in the outside of the hip. Studies that have mixed evidence include shoulder pain, so rotator cuff tendinopathies or impingement syndrome involving the shoulder. PRP, some studies say it helps a lot. Some studies continue to show mixed evidence. Much less well-studied indications include patellar tendinopathy as well as Achilles tendinopathy. What do I need to do before a PRP injection? By far the most important thing that you need to do before a PRP injection, and this is actually 2 weeks before a PRP injection, is you need to stop all non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications. These medications include aspirin and ibuprofen and naproxen and Celebrex and meloxicam and indomethacin and diclofenac. And the reason you need to stop all of these medications 2 weeks before your injection date is because all of these medications work by inhibiting platelets. So if you take one of these medications and then we do your injection, we take your platelets out and we inject them back in, we are injecting blinks. You are not going to get a good result. Now, the actual timing of when you are supposed to stop your platelet antiplatelet medications is actually debated. Some doctors say 1 week, some doctors say three days before, some doctors say 5 days before. I am very conservative because I want my patients to have a great and excellent outcome. So I say 2 weeks before the injection, you stop all of your NSAID type medications. The second thing you can do before your PRP injection is about 1 week before your injection, you can increase the amount of cardio exercise that you are doing. And this could be walking, this could be jogging, this can be getting on a stationary bike. Cardio exercise will actually increase your body's production of blood cells, and that can increase your platelet counts. The next thing that I ask my patients to do before a PRP injection is to really examine their diet. Now, I know, a doctor telling a patient about their diet, this is nothing new, but this actually really matters. numbers when it comes to PRP. I have done so many injections in patients who do have high cholesterol or they have high triglycerides. And when I get their PRP, instead of being a nice, beautiful, clear yellow product, it's actually milky yellow. And that's milky yellow because of all the processed meats and the fatty foods and the fried foods and the fast foods that they eat, rather than focusing on vegetables and fruit, natural foods that just have better health benefits and affect your blood cells. The next thing is to drink plenty of water. Again, this is something that is just gonna help with your overall health and your overall function. It helps with body circulation, it helps with energy, it helps with brain function. What I recommend people is to drink half their body weight in fluid ounces. So for example, if you weigh 150 pounds, you should be aiming for 75 fluid ounces per day. The last thing is to get a good night's rest. Aim for anywhere between 7 to 9 hours. And sleep is incredibly important in how our bodies recover and how our bodies heal. And when we don't get good sleep or we get insufficient sleep, our bodies release a lot of stress hormones, and these can potentially affect how your body's gonna function. So what do I need to know after a PRP injection? Well, the first thing that you need to do is you need to continue to hold your NSAID class of medications. Continue holding it for 2 weeks after the injection, and the longer the better. If you can extend that all the way up to 6 weeks or discontinue it altogether, that would be ideal. You're also going to want to avoid strenuous activity and limit excessive loading of the body part that was just injected. We want to give your platelets time to work. Now, if you need to go grocery shopping or you need to do house chores, usually that is totally okay, but you should check with your doctor about what kinds of restrictions you have after your injection. Now, I also ask my patients to apply heat for 10 minutes at a time, 3 times a day, for the first 3 days after a PRP injection. And the reason for this is, number one, heat is just gonna help with some of that soreness that you're gonna have after a PRP injection. But number two is more theoretical. If we think back to high school chemistry, if we want to slow down a reaction, what do? We put it on ice. If we want to speed up a reaction, we actually add heat. So by adding heat to whatever body part was just injected, we are actually increasing the platelet signaling and hoping for a faster outcome. Now, it's really important to understand that the rehabilitation after a PRP injection is going to add significant value and promote recovery. And so what you want to do is you're going to want to restart your home exercise program or go to physical therapy about 1 week after your injection and gradually ramp up your activity. When can I expect relief? Well, the answer to this question really depends on the indication. It really depends on what we are trying to treat. Joints tend to respond a lot faster than tendons. People with joint injections, for example, if I'm treating someone with knee arthritis, I actually tell them you will be expected to notice some relief within 4 to 6 weeks after one injection. Tendons take much, much, much longer. Tendons can take up to 12 weeks before people start to notice effects. But you gotta keep in mind that when we do a PRP injection, this is very different than taking ibuprofen. This is very different than getting a cortisone injection. Taking NSAIDs, getting cortisone injections, those medications work fast. With PRP injections, we are playing the long game. We are changing the tissue. We are changing the environment of a joint, and that takes time. We're working on the cellular level. Things like that don't happen right away. So with PRP, we're really playing the long game rather than getting short, quick, but not long-lasting effects with all these other treatment options. How many shots do I need to start feeling better? Well, again, it really depends on the indication. Joints, such as arthritis, when we're treating knee osteoarthritis, it can take up to 3 injections for people to start noticing dramatic and significant pain relief. Tendons are different. Tendons usually only need 1 injection for people to start noticing an effect. But again, every clinical situation is different. Every patient is different. And so this really does need to be individualized. Are there any side effects to a PRP injection? The short answer is no. It is your own body. We are using your own cells, your own platelets, your own growth factors. There is zero risk for an allergic type reaction that you might get with other types of injections, such as a hyaluronic acid injection. Now, with that said, some people do have a local inflammatory reaction after a PRP injection. And the reason that some people get this is their body's response to the release of an incredible amount of platelets and growth factors. This is usually a self-limited condition. It usually resolves on its own after 24 hours. Do PRP injections help regenerate tissue? Well, as of right now, there is no clinical trial or scientific evidence that shows that PRP injections help regenerate anything. Now, with that said, a lot of people are looking into this question. Preliminary results of MRI studies looking at people with knee arthritis who get PRP injections suggest that there could actually be changes in the knee. Where can I find more information about PRP injections and very specific indications? Well, you can check out the playlist section on my YouTube channel where I take deep dive videos into common indications such as knee arthritis, hip arthritis, elbow tendinopathies like golfer's elbow and tennis elbow, and plantar fasciitis. I will constantly update and add to this playlist as new clinical trials are being published. If you found this information useful, please consider liking the video and sharing with others. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.